Now let us discuss with the concept called as the effect of substituents on acidic nature of carboxylic acids. So when we study the effect of substituents on acidic nature of carboxylic acids, there are two different types of substituents. One may be electron releasing substituents, or I can also call it as electron donating groups. Electron releasing substituents or electron donating groups. And the second part, as I have already said, and the second part is known as electron withdrawing groups, which is popularly called as EWG. So first let us know which are the common electron donating groups. The electron donating groups are majorly alkynes. All alkyl groups are electron donating, which is represented by R. OH group is electron donating, NH2 is electron donating, etc. And when it comes to electron withdrawing, nitro group is the strongest electron withdrawing group. Cyanide is an electron withdrawing group. Halogens, these are the electron donating and electron withdrawing groups. Now let us discuss what happens when an electron donating group is attached to carboxylic acid. First point, when an electron donating group is attached to carboxylic acid, the acidic strength of carboxylic acid, acidic strength of carboxylic acid goes on decreases. Acidic strength of carboxylic acid goes on decreases. Now a question comes, why it goes on decreases? It decreases due to positive inductive effect of electron donating group. Because for example, if I take RCOOH, if this R is electron donating in its nature, extra electron density increases on oxygen atom. When the extra electron density increases on oxygen atom, more number of negative charge or maximum negative charge will be present on this oxygen atom, which destabilizes the carboxylate ion. Due to that particular reason, the acidic strength of carboxylic acid goes on decreases. Suppose when I consider the different electron donating groups like hydrogen, methyl, ethyl, as well as propyl, the acidic strength will be greater in hydrogen as compared to that of other alkyl groups. Means when we move from hydrogen towards the propyl group, the acidic nature or the acidic character decreases. This in turn explains one more concept, that as the length of alkyl group increases, the acidic strength goes on decreases. This is the conclusion with reference to the first concept, that is electron donating groups, or I can also call it as electron releasing groups. Majorly when we start with electron withdrawing groups, these electron withdrawing groups increases the electron withdrawing groups increases the acidic strength of carboxylic acid. So how the acidic strength of carboxylic acid goes on increases? It is due to minus I effect. So minus I effect of what? Electron withdrawing group. So minus I effect of electron withdrawing group means the group withdraws the electrons, or the group take away carboxylate ion. When the group take away the electrons from the carboxylate ion, the extra electron density goes on, decreases on oxygen atom. The extra electron density goes on, decreases on oxygen atom. When the extra electron density goes on, decreases, migration of electron can take place, which stabilizes the carboxylate ion, which stabilizes the carboxylate ion in a carboxylic acid. By this, we can clearly explain that the acidic strength of carboxylic acid goes on increases when an electron withdrawing group is attached to it. Added to this, one more important concept explains that as the number of electron withdrawing group goes on increases, the acidic strength also increases. Even you should know this. The meaning is, as the number of electron withdrawing groups goes on increases, the acidic character or the acidic strength also goes on increases. By this, we can clearly explain by taking an example of, this is ClCH2COOH, which is known as chloroacetic acid. The second one is called as Cl2CHCOOH. This is known as dichloroacetic acid. And this is known as trichloroacetic acid. And this is just an acetic acid. So, in this trichloroacetic acid, there are three halogen atoms present. Here two halogens, here only one halogen. So it means that trichloroacetic acid is more acidic. So chloroacetic acid is less acidic than trichloroacetic acid, and this dichloroacetic acid is less acidic as compared to trichloroacetic acid. By this, I can clearly understand that as the number of electron withdrawing groups goes on increases, the acidic strength of carboxylic acids also increases.